Hi, welcome to the next episode in the series named From Zero to Pentesting Hero, where we analyze the code in search of security vulnerabilities. Today, we are going to talk about Ruby language. We will take a look at a simple implementation of the proxy server. But first, what is a proxy server? Sometimes, some websites are blocked in a companies. How such filters work is simple. They check what URL the computer connects to, and if this address is blocked, it does not allow to make a connection. And here, the proxy server comes in handy. There are many of them. It's easy to find them in the internet. In such case, we provide the address that we want to connect to. Then, the website downloads the content of the website using its resources and returns it to us in a text format. Because it's not us who entered the given address, the firewall is not aware that we are connecting to the blocked website. Here, I have a very simple implementation of such service in Ruby. We are going to use the webbrick module to quickly create a web server. Next, we pass the URL parameter from the user to the open function and display the content it will return. Let's check how this code sample works. As you can see, I received the content of the external site. Now, let's go to defining vulnerabilities. This code contained two of them. First, server-side request forgery. On the same server, I also have a running instance of phpMyAdmin tool that is used for database management. It is configured in such way that it's impossible to access it from the outside. We can connect to this address only from localhost. But what will happen if we provide this address as a parameter to our goal? The content will be downloaded. Why? Because the gateway and the phpMyAdmin are available on the same server. How to protect yourself against this vulnerability? By using external modules, for example, SSRF filter, which checks whether the address given by the user does not point to the resources on local computer. But it's not everything. The open function has one more interesting functionality. If the parameter that is passed to it begins with a vertical line, that is, pipe, it's not treated as a URL, but as a comment to execute in the console. So if we enter pipe dir instead of URL, we will get a list of files in the current directory, not a website as one could expect. Very interesting functionality that is probably known by only a few users. As you can see, creating a secure proxy server is not so easy. And that's all in today's episode. If you enjoyed it, feel free to comment, like, and subscribe to this channel. See you in the next episode. Bye.